welcome to Catalan News. Europe can't have an entire government in jail or exiled. This was Carles Puigdemont's main message in his first interview after being released by a judge in Brussels. He and his four deposed ministers in Belgium have urged the European Union to react to Spain's incarceration of 10 pro-independence leaders in what they call a violation of human rights. They are still in Belgium and they had an important visit today. Here at Catalan News, we'll tell you all about it and we'll also get you the latest on the strike called for tomorrow. Let's begin. The Catalan president, Carles Puigdemont, deposed by the Spanish government, is waiting for the Belgian justice system to decide whether to extradite him or not. But in the meantime, he and his only four ministers not in jail are determined to take advantage of their stay in the European capital by denouncing Spain's harsh measures to stop the pro-independence roadmap. They held their first joint interview today with the Catalan public radio station, but they are aiming to get their message across to a much wider audience.
Spain is violating human rights in Catalonia. This is how President Puigdemont and his four ministers in Belgium see the latest actions carried out by the Spanish government and courts. The former officials made it clear this morning. This was their first interview since a Belgian judge released them while deciding whether or not to extradite them to Spain. They are to appear in court again on November 17th. Meanwhile, they're not wasting their time. They want to denounce not only Spain, but also the European Union in its tolerance of the direct rule imposed on Catalonia and the imprisonment of officials.
La desconnexió absoluta entre aquesta elite eurocràtica que obeeix només als estats, que ha traït els valors, que s'ha corromput en la defensa dels valors fundacionals d'Europa, desconnectada del que de fet li interessa a la gent.
Puigdemont once more called for the prisoners to be freed, despite admitting that he might also end up in prison in the coming weeks. He also predicted that their case would be taken to international courts. According to him, this would be a serious embarrassment for Spain. During the interview, he also referred to the December 21st elections and the possibility of running as part of a joint candidacy.
És que hi hagi una llista, diguem-ne, de país, una llista amplíssima, que hi hagi tot el govern, que hi hagi tota la gent que està defensant la democràcia, totes les sensibilitats.
Puigdemont insisted that the only way to reach independence is through freedom, democracy, and without the violence carried out by Spain.
Around 200 Catalan mayors have traveled to Brussels today in order to support the officials in the city. They want to make the Catalan issue even more international, and that's why they've shown a poster earlier today outside the European Commission. They want to demand the release of the 8 ministers in jail. In fact, the mayors are still in Brussels, where they've held this evening an event to defend the last elected Catalan government. Some MEPs have taken part, along with the presidents of 2 major Catalan associations of towns, and also Puigdemont himself. Brussels is still a center of attention for Catalan politics, but Catalonia and Madrid are gaining ground as the December 21st election approaches. A spokesman for Spain's ruling party, the People's Party, has said that direct rule over Catalonia might be reimposed after the election. In theory, when a new president is appointed, the dramatic measures against Catalan self-rule would come to an end. Yet the spokesman said that if someone tries to violate the constitution, Mariano Rajoy's answer will be the same. In the meantime, parties are still discussing whether they will hold joint candidacies. Left-wing Catalunya en Comú will join forces with Podemos, but some 8 officials have resigned in disagreement. The chances pro-independence parties make a unity candidacy look scarce at the moment. Not only are Catalan officials facing the Spanish justice system in relation to the independence debate. 8 Catalan teachers appeared in court today over hate speech allegations. Families of students in La Seu d'Urgell in the Catalan Pyrenees have accused teachers of criticizing the Spanish police for their role in the October 1st referendum when they violently cracked down on voters. Accusations that the teachers dismissed as false. Allegedly, a student was even victim of aggressions for being the son of a Guardia Civil officer. After the hearing today, the judge decided to continue the investigation. Tomorrow, Catalonia faces a second general strike in just over a month to demand the release of imprisoned Catalan officials. Despite uncertainty over whether it will go ahead, Catalan unions, civic organizations, and political parties will sign up to it.
Catalonia sees its second general strike in just over a month. Tomorrow, Catalan unions, civic organizations, and political parties will take part in a stoppage to demand the release of imprisoned Catalan ministers. Despite uncertainty over whether the strike would go ahead, the stoppage is taking shape, with the CGT, the Coordinadora Obrera Sindical, and USTEC unions all joining up on Tuesday. The strike to demand the release of imprisoned Catalan officials also has the support of the ANC and Òmnium Cultural pro-independent civic organizations. Despite the UGT and CCOO unions deciding not to join the strike, arguing that the reasons for the stoppage are political, both organizations called on the public to join the demonstrations.
Per tant, és un dia, sobretot, de que mirem d'unir-nos a tots, de sumar, que no busquem les diferències del dia 8, si uns fem una cosa i uns altres fem una altra, sinó que la immensa majoria de la societat catalana es mobilitzi i surti al carrer en la forma que vulgui. S'ha de ser respectuós.
Both the CCOO and UGT unions are calling for the release of the Catalan officials and the also imprisoned heads of ANC and Òmnium, as well as the withdrawal of Article 155 imposing direct rule on Catalonia from Madrid. Along with major unions and the ANC and Òmnium supporting the stoppage, the strike is also backed by the Defence Committees of the Republic, which in recent days has organised the blocking of roads and railway lines in protest over the imprisonments. Tomorrow, the Defence Committees of the Republic is expected to again block much of Catalonia's transport infrastructure. Protests have also been called outside town halls and in the Cathedral Square in Barcelona at 6 p.m. It is the second such protest in little over a month, after the successful general strike on October the 3rd to protest Spanish police brutality during the October 1st referendum.
An anti-independence rally in the Catalan town of Sant Cugat del Vallès on Monday ended with protesters tearing down a banner hanging from the city council reading "Freedom, political prisoners, democracy." Previously, demonstrators had egged the sign and some confronted Catalan police officers who were guarding the building. Some far-right supporters were among the crowd, and a member of anti-immigration Plataforma per Catalunya even rallied the crowd using a megaphone. The city council has condemned the violence and says it will replace the banner. In other news, the Catalan economy continued to grow in the third quarter of 2017, up by 0.9% more than the same period last year. Catalan industry enjoyed an increase of 3.7% compared to 2016, and GDP stood at 3.5%, half a point higher than the second quarter. The construction industry also continues to thrive, along with the service sector, which both saw enduring growth despite the ongoing tensions between Catalonia and Spain. Foreign tourism also rose by 7.8% compared to last year, higher than the average for Spain as a whole. And the holidays are getting closer here in Catalonia, and with them a unique Catalan tradition, the Caganer. And this year, this bizarre nativity statuette reflects current events more than ever before.
In many countries, the onset of Christmas also brings elaborate nativity scenes. In Catalonia, this picture has an added character, the Caganer. A Caganer is a peasant in traditional Catalan dress, trousers dropped, defecating. These clay figurines have become typical, if bizarre, Catalan souvenirs. Every holiday season, they get reinvented as important personalities from the past year. 2017 is no different, and the Catalan pro-independence movement plays a starring role. Jailed pro-independence leaders Jordi Cuixart and Jordi Sánchez, the post-Catalan police chief Josep Lluís Trapero, and politicians Anna Gabriel and Gabriel Rufián have all been immortalized as new 2017 Caganers. There are even ballot boxes and figures holding protest signs and Catalan independence flags. These were all handmade by one of the foremost companies in the field, family-owned Caganers.com. This year, they're celebrating the 25th anniversary of bringing new ideas to the table.
Bueno, la veritat és que el repte sempre és sorprendre. És sorprendre l'actualitat, és poder arribar, quan comencem fires, amb moltes novetats que formin l'actualitat del dia a dia, perquè al final quan treus una peça que ja ha quedat fora de l'actualitat, és una peça que no es ven.
While the United States is the company's biggest customer, they foresee France becoming the runner-up. French President Emmanuel Macron has his own Caganer as well, along with Venezuelan President Nicolas Maduro and Korean President Kim Jong-un. There are 46 new statuettes, all answering the call of nature. Fictional characters from video games, Star Wars and Star Trek also make an appearance, alongside athletes and celebrities. Even pioneering Catalan chefs, Ferran Adrià and the Roca brothers, have made it to the Hall of Fame.
That's all for us today. Tomorrow Catalan News will be taking part in a countrywide general strike, but we'll be back in force on Thursday. We leave you with some images from the MACBA's latest exhibition entitled Focus at Infinity, the first institutional retrospective of the lesser-known but highly accomplished artist Rosemary Castoro. Born and raised in New York, she sadly passed away in 2015. Thanks for watching and see you in a couple of days.